It is 5:15 already. I managed to edit one video and it's uploading right now. I'm gonna do some shopping now, so some bananas, some water, maybe some donuts, so I can have some breakfast in the morning. I bought myself some drinks and breakfast for the next 2 days. I'm a little bit hungry right now, so before we go to the Peppermill Casino, I want to try out this coupon. It's $5 off of a $20 meal. I am still getting lost in this casino, looking for the bar and grill. It's hard to find, but we will get there, hopefully. Okay, we found it. Apparently it's on 3rd Street. I just had a nice dinner here at the Copa Bar and Grill. So together with the beer it was $21. And we get $5 off with the coupon, so it was $16. But the service was really good. Very friendly, fast. Very good service. So I paid $4 tip, so it was $20 for this dinner. Yeah, it was good. It was not the best I had ever had, the best steak or best ribs, but it was also not bad, so it was a lot of food. It's almost 7 p.m. right now, so it's a good time to get over to the Peppermill. Played for like 2 hours here at the Peppermill. First of all, I have to say that the poker room is really nice, really good. It's by far the best poker room that I've played in so far during this trip. It's really classy and the chairs are really nice. Also, they give you free soda, water and soup for the poker players, so non-alcoholic drinks are free. Also, the service is very good and they play a lot of games. They had like 4 1-2 tables open when I came in, so yes, it's a really good experience to play here at the Peppermill. So I will go back again to play some more tonight. But first, let me tell you how it went so far. The first 2 hours went good. Not great, but it was good. I won $63, so not too bad. So let me tell you about a couple of the hands that I played. The first half hour there was not much action. I had to fold a lot of hands, so I decided to straddle on the button. They do the Mississippi straddle here. That means you can straddle for any amount from any position you're in. So I decided to straddle on the button to generate some action. There were 3 players calling and I had the King 7 offsuit, so I decided to just check and see the flop. The flop was really nice, it was 7-7-8. It was checked to me and I checked also for a little bit of deception. The turn was a jack and it was checked to me, and now I bet $10 and I get one caller. The river is a queen. Now the guy who called me, he bets 11, so I just decide to call his $11, and he has king jack, so he has only one pair, so I win that pot. after that I'm carded again for 3 hours, for 3 more rounds.
What the hell?
Shut up. Then finally I get pocket aces. I have pocket aces in early position, so I decide to bet $7. A little bit on the low side, but this is a very loose table, so I decided to just make it 7, and what I was hoping for happened. Some other player, he raised to 20. One player called my 7, and then late position player raised to 20. I re-raised to 50, and both of them decided to call me. It was really nice, considering I have been playing only like 2 or 3 hands in the last 5 rounds, so I was playing pretty tight. The flop was jack 4-8 rainbow, and I had about 130 left in my stack, so I decided to just go all in. And yeah, unfortunate, or maybe good for me, is that they both folded, so I won a nice pot of around $100. Then nothing much happened. I can see some cheap flops, but I miss everything, so I have to fold. And after the first hour, I'm up around $63. Then something interesting happens. The player on my left decides to leave, and there are 2 really loose aggressive players at my table. They both have big stacks, and one of them decides to take the seat next to me, and the other decides to take the other open seat. So now they are both sitting directly on the left of me, which is not good. So let me give you another poker tip. You don't want loose aggressive big stack players on your left, because that's a sure way of losing money. Playing poker is not only about the cards you get and how you play them, but also what position you have on the table relative to the other players. So I could not have them sitting on my left, of course, so I immediately decided to move also, and I took the open spot that was now on the left side of those 2 aggressive players. So now I have 2 loose aggressive big stacks on my right, and that is the perfect position to have in poker, because if they play really loose and aggressive, you can play just very tight and only call when you have a really big hand. So they didn't look too happy when I decided to move, but yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. I've got one more important poker tip for you. And one thing I noticed is that a lot of poker players don't wash their hands when they go to the bathroom afterwards. So when you've been playing poker and you've touching all the chips and the table and the cards, don't eat any food with your hands before you washed your hands. That's very important. I did win maybe a few small pots, but nothing really interesting to talk about. Then one of the loose aggressive players on my right starts getting into maniac mode. He plays like every hand, and he raises pre-flop to anywhere between $15 and $40 pre-flop. So, and it has been 2 hours already I've been playing, so it was time to go anyway. So that's why I decided to leave the game. I ended up winning $62 in 2 hours. Not bad, considering that I didn't get much hands. Basically only won all that money with my aces and played tight enough so I didn't lose it all back again to those aggressive players. So I've been on a break for about 30-40 minutes now, so it's time to get back to the poker room and put in another session of 1-2. I played one more hour here at the Pepper Mill. At first the game was very good. There was a lot of loose aggressive players at the table. Not really much hands to talk about. I won a couple of small pots, nothing big. After about 30 minutes people started to leave. One guy left because I felt at him when I made my straight. We were only six-handed play for like 15 minutes, and everybody was just limping and seeing the flop, and there was not much action anymore, so I decided to quit. I won $30, so that's a good thing. It was a lot of fun playing here at the Pepper Mill. It's a really nice poker room, good dealers, very quick, very friendly, very nice dealers they have here. Also the rest of the staff and the waitresses, it's all very good. So I can recommend playing at the Pepper Mill for anybody. If you want to play 1-2, 2-4, 5-10, they've got it all, and it's one of the best poker rooms I've seen so far. I say thank you for watching, and if you like these videos, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I will see you in the next video, which will probably be tomorrow. Good night.